there was a cry for help from this community where we are now. Just beyond the trees here was a hole in the ground that was being filled with refuse at night, some of medical waste, and there were rats starting to infest homes along Lynx Lane. We said, what's going on? Who owns this property? It turns out that the county owns the property that was being dumped on. And I was the county legislator.
A potential automobile byway that would pass through our community into a pedestrian, environmentally friendly greenway.
We don't want to have a byway here with fast speeding traffic. The land that you're standing on, even in the 1980s, was being used for community little league baseball. This was a baseball field on the state property. Wonderful. I would come down here and I would see the children playing, and I'd say to myself, gosh, this shouldn't be a speedway.
One of the priorities of my agency is to get kids off the couch, out of the living room, away from the TVs and computers, and outside. And there's no better way to do it.
Today for the ribbon cutting, but I see a lot of my fellow rebels who have been walking this path for a while. I've been walking with my husband and my dog, and just marveling at the beauty of it and the wonderful sense of sharing a community with my neighbors. It's such an antithesis of the negative parts of suburban living, which separates people and isolates people. This path has brought people together.
I expanded, and we got those three, as the assembly had said, actually almost four county parks. We need to add ball fields to this beautiful necklace, as the assemblyman Engelbert calls it, a necklace that would connect and make it somewhat safer for our kids to get to these athletic fields that are yet to be built.
When the phase two and three are finished, you all have a unique opportunity to travel from where we have ring tech for the Setauket post office. You'll be traveling through old farmland, through an old growth forest, through neighborhood meadows, into an old industrial site, really, and then eventually up to Fort Gestation and beyond.
When you really combine what Mike Cosell, right there, is doing with rails to trails for 14 miles out to Wading River from the top of Fort Gestation, with the 3 miles and we have here, linking to the 6 miles on the university campus, you are the bike capital of Long Island.